Welcome to Suncoast View. I'm Stephanie Roberts. Moldy meals at a Sarasota elementary school, plus a sleep position survey and the sexiest man alive. Lots to discuss.
I'm Haley Wilgus. Designing Women Boutique is here with a fashion show of gorgeous gala gowns to kick off the newest venue at Selby Gardens.
I'm Bo Beth, and I love weekend getaways, and I think I'm a pretty good packer. Today, we'll try a carry-on challenge, plus the financial impact of the election in Money Matters.
And I'm Linda Carson. It's a triple bill at the Sarasota Ballet this weekend, and there are three diva roles that we would be perfect for. Don't miss our dance audition. All that and more right now on Suncoast View.
Welcome to the show. That is the Sarasota Military Academy drum line. A great way to kick off our show this afternoon. And it's something we wanted to share with you because we get to enjoy this practically every day here at ABC 7. We are right across the street from Sarasota Military Academy. And when I take our little puppy Wrigley out, I often get to hear the drum line, and I love it. So we invited him to come on over and say hi.
I was dancing. What'd you guys do with the music?
Yeah, it'll come back. It'll come back.
I used to play the cymbals in high school. So I did mention to the drumline instructor that I am available if one of the girls.
Oh, you are. You could just run across the street and fill in.
Nobody'd ever notice the difference.
You don't think?
Right.
I don't know about fitting in those uniforms.
I was going to say you sparkle a little more than they do at this point. But no, a lot of talent, a lot of precision, and just a really cool institution right here in Sarasota and right across the street. So congrats to the drumline and thanks for stopping by. Welcome to the show and welcome back to Haley. Wilgus.
Oh, glad to be here. Yeah.
We have
happy
lots
to be here.
Lots of fun on the way for today, but first we do want to head to the kitchen and say hello to Chef Andreas from J-Pan. What
Hi,
are we making
are
today? Good, thank you.
Thank you for having me.
What are we making?
I'm trying to make a sukune.
A who? Oh,
sukune.
A sukune. What's a sukune?
Sukune is a Japanese chicken meatball.
Okay, chicken meatball we know. A Japanese chicken meatball.
Correct.
I have never heard of that, but J-Pan has lots of creative things on their menu, and among them some of the great sushi that you're seeing right there, but we will also learn about sukune. Linda, it's a new word every day for us in the kitchen.
Sukune. I'll order that next time I'm out.
That's good. All right, we look forward to that. Haley, you are so active in the community. We love following you on Facebook and all the different things that you do. Cliff Rolls took a great picture of you. I don't know if you got a chance to see it.
I did see this.
But here you are at the Lilly Pulitzer Luncheon. Tell us about the luncheon.
So every year, the past few years, Junior League has been pairing up with Lilly Pulitzer to raise money for some of the programs. I'm also part of Junior League. And the programs that we raise money for, specifically this year, our focus is on hunger in our community. Mm-hmm. And there are several other programs that we support as well, but that's our big push for this year and the past couple years. So the money raised goes toward that. But it's a really fun luncheon. Everyone's dressed in Lilly. We model Lilly, and that's what you were seeing there. And it's just a lot of fun. It's like a sea of prints and pink and green and just total girliness. So
that
it's a lot of
really
fun.
Pretty on you.
Thank you. Thank you. It was a good time. And we raised a lot of money. So that's the best part.
Good.
Yeah.
That is the point. All right.
Yep.
Good for that. And then we found something else fun to share with you because we know you are a huge Aggie fan.
I am.
And as you know, the mannequin challenge.
Right.
Very in right now on social media. This is Texas A&M's gymnastic team. Okay. Freezing in a position is one thing, but freezing in these
I know.
Positions.
That's
amazing.
Whoa.
A bunch of my friends
totally
shared
cool.
this on Facebook. So I saw this and I was just really impressed. Actually, I mentioned
look
it.
Look at
to
that.
I know, hanging,
toes.
Right? Yeah.
And in the pike position,
yes.
These are serious muscles. That would be me. I could hang out in the blocks upside down.
Head down.
Challenge, you guys.
Well, it's funny you say that. My kids have been telling me that all week. Why haven't you done one on the show?
Yeah,
why haven't you done
one
on the show?
One.
So we probably need to come up with
come
the creative
with
way to do a good mannequin challenge.
It'd be hard to find us doing those things
well,
that we
I won't
just
be
looked
doing
at.
It.
Yeah, it won't be those positions. And very honestly, we don't sit still very well, in case you
so
haven't noticed.
Having
so the whole thing would probably be a challenge for us. But we'll give it a try. We're up for it. We can see how it goes. All right, it is time for our first hot topic. Health Department officials are visiting a Sarasota elementary school today after parents complained their kids were served moldy food. So a mom took pictures of moldy bread and moldy jelly that was served to kids in the cafeteria for breakfast at Gosio Elementary. The school says it is the second issue in a week with the individually packaged jelly and blames the manufacturer. All moldy food was removed. No one has been reported sick. Okay, not to make light of this, because obviously in terms of school and health concerns and all that, we have to make sure our food was fresh. But I got to tell you, I don't know how you grew up, but when I was growing up, a little mold just got it trimmed off the edge, and it still got served. Anyone want to fess up to that?
I can remember my mother doing that with bread, just cutting that part off.
No, my mom would have never done. My mom is much more of, she's a nurse, but she's much more of a germaphobe than I am. She even said to me when we were staying together in a hotel when she came to visit, she's like, I'm glad you're not such a germaphobe. You didn't get that from me, you know, because she would have never, we would have never eaten anything that had been near moldy.
It's just a little protein.
I don't know if it's protein, but it's something organic. Yeah.
We never, but she would cut some off.
Absolutely. You guys eat cheese. You drink
There's moldy cheese.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, and when they mentioned the jelly, I kind of thought to myself, oh, and again, not to make light of it, we don't want kids in school to eat mold, but you
absolutely
know,
not.
We had
That's
some
really
mold issues funny. Inside of our jelly jar last week, and I just took a paper towel, wiped that issue out, and made the sandwich. I thought, oh,
But these are other people's children.
Absolutely.
That's the difference, I think. You know, you can do things at your home that you wouldn't want to happen at a school because they may not control it the same way you will.
Exactly. Yes. And I do not want anyone feeding my child moldy food other than me. I probably shouldn't be admitting it anyway. But
you probably shouldn't be feeding the moldy food, but you know.
But you know, I had a sinking suspicion. We have all probably been there.
I have definitely been there.
Trying to make you feel better at the elementary. You're not alone.
I had that issue last week, and I didn't want to go to the grocery store, and then part of my bread had mold on it, and I was like, well, what are the options here? I can either eat around the piece that's still good, or I can go to the grocery store, and I opted to eat around the piece that was still good.
And you're still here to tell about
it. Yeah.
It's all good. Well, journalism pioneer Gwen Ifill has died after a battle with cancer. The co-anchor of PBS NewsHour was part of the first all-female network evening news anchor team with Judy Woodruff. She covered 7 presidential campaigns and moderated 2 vice presidential debates and authored a book about race and politics at the beginning of the Obama administration. Ifill took leave from PBS earlier this year without ever making her illness public. Gwen Ifill was 61 years old. And Linda, I thought you would really appreciate this, knowing how far and how hard,
she
fought and how hard it was in the beginning.
She always had to be better than everybody else, better than the man, work harder than the man, be more serious. You didn't dare laugh or make jokes back then because you had to show that you were serious. And seeing Judy Woodruff there, back in the 60s, I was a reporter in Atlanta and she applied for a job at my station and they said, oh no, we already have a blonde. We couldn't hire you. And she didn't get the job. Now she did go into Washington and she was a national anchor, but she couldn't get hired because one blonde's enough.
Wow. Right. No, absolutely. To me, that's just someone. And Haley, I know through your years of studying that was always just considered a solid, reputable journalist that, you know, kept her nose to the ground, kept herself out of trouble, and just really was a good example of, you know, our industry at work.
And that's hard.
For me, you know, for me it was more than that. Like, when I graduated Syracuse, I was having a hard time getting an on-air position. It would be the same thing. You always have that one black reporter. And seeing her made me think, you know what, it is possible, even though the agents will say no, or even though the station will say no, I know that at some point I will get to another or get to a station I want to be at.
Absolutely. A lot of it's timing and a lot of it's trailblazing.
And a lot of it is just keeping on pushing.
Right. Yeah.
Just never giving up.
The thing is, when you see people like her at you know, doing well, it's the inspiration to continue that.
Right.
That
it's also an inspiration to the news directors and the people hiring is, wow, a black woman can be really good. Yeah. What a breakthrough.
Who knows?
Right. Go figure.
Who knows?
Well, can how you sleep affect your health? Experts say there is no one perfect sleep position, and most of us switch it up during the night anyway. Okay, but listen up here. Stomach sleepers, you run the risk of neck strain and chronic pain problems. But here's a fun upside. You have more sex dreams. Hey, Linda, you sleep on your stomach?
I sleep on my side.
Okay, well, side sleepers inadvertently compress nerves in your arms and legs, and that happens to me. You wake up and one side will be stiff because you were on your side for too long. Well, nightmares are also more common for side sleepers. Now, back sleepers have less neck and back pain than the rest of us, but they're more likely to snore, my husband, and have sleep apnea. So I'm a side sleeper, and
I am a side sleeper, and I'm very popular on trips because I never move. So if I go on a trip with girlfriends and we have to share a bed, everybody wants to sleep with me because I never move once during the night.
You know what? And I know who in my girl group is that person, too. Yes, because sharing a bed is difficult if you've got a flailer.
Right. Yeah, and somebody rolls over and puts their arm around you.
Yeah, it gets all touchy. But Beth, how do you sleep?
I'm a stomach sleeper, and I don't move very much.
Okay. And you don't? Does your neck ever bother you, your back? Because that is hard.
When I wake up, yes. When I wake up, I have to stretch my back, but I rather that because I always worry about rolling off the bed for some reason.
Oh. And do you have good sex dreams? Because that was supposed to be part of it.
What kind of question?
I know, but it came out of the study. It came out of the study.
I don't know what kind of dreams I have.
Okay,
that's okay. You know, for years.
Who just asked the person, do you have good sex dreams?
Part of the study said stomach sleepers have good sex dreams. I'm dreaming.
I don't know.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Haley, I'll spare you, but what side do you sleep on, or do you?
I usually am a side sleeper. I mean, I have all these neck and back problems, so they always say to sleep on your back for that. Mm-hmm. But and I do sometimes end up on my back later, but I just can't fall asleep just like
no,
in
I
that.
No, I can't place. Either.
I don't know how people
well,
do that.
I used to sleep on my face because we wore these plastic rollers in our hair at
night.
Yeah,
and you couldn't sleep
so
on them,
right. So you went to bed with plastic rollers in your head. And you
face down?
I started sleeping on my stomach because of my lower body is so much bigger than the rest of me, so I can't sleep on my back. It's uncomfortable.
Okay.
So and that's how I ended up on my stomach.
And I don't like being touched. I'm a personal space person, so if I sleep on the side, I can go all the way to the edge of the bed.
I'm sure your husband loves that.
Yeah, we won't get into that conversation. And yes, I deserve that. So People Magazine has named the sexiest man alive for this year. He's an actor, a producer, and a wrestler, and now Dwayne The Rock Johnson is also the sexiest man alive. He's 44 years old. He's had quite a year. He's transitioned from wrestling to Hollywood. And here's something I didn't know. He is now the highest paid actor in the world.
Wow.
I didn't even know how that happened. Mm. Disney's Mona comes out next week, and he is starring in that. It's supposed to be a huge hit. Plus, Rock the Troops is coming out for military families on December 13th. He's the dad of two teen daughters and is described as sweet, smart, and sculpted. What do
sculpted?
You think?
I get
sculpted,
that.
Yes. And I'm also wondering why you guys chose the video you chose. Because, you know, if you're going to talk about the sexiest man alive, we need to see shirtless.
You want skin?
You know, we need to see some pecs moving like
Matt,
he does in that movie.
Matt in Orlando, our producer and editor, probably didn't care whether his shirt was on or off. So I guess next time I will specify.
I mean, if you're going to say sexiest man alive, I need
you
to
want
see
some
the
skin.
Product.
You need proof. Yeah.
I do like him, though. I do.
He's a good
and
guy. He's a really good guy.
Sweet,
I hardly ever agree with these sexiest man alive picks. I can't even remember the last time I did, but I really like him. I mean, I don't know if I find him sexy, but I like him
as a person. I think the good part about this is it's not just external.
It's right, it's
you actually really like the personality, and it's also amazing to me because he does a lot of children
movies. He does, mm-hmm. Yeah.
So the fact that that appeal comes from that versus, I don't know, an action or something.
Or some bad boy.
Or
I like
magic
that he's a good guy.
Yeah,
yeah.
He feels safe. I
right.
look at him,
oh,
and
he would,
gives
yeah.
me a
I bet he would keep
safe.
You
he would protect
yes,
you.
Yes, he could take pretty much anybody out, and that is sexy, by the way. I find that protector thing sexy. All right, well, the mannequin challenge, of course, all over social media. We showed you Texas A&M's, but we can't keep up because now there's a new craze popping up. It's called Andy's Coming. Check it out.
Hey, preserve your positions now.
Andy's coming, everybody. Back to your places. Hurry.
Okay, so that's what it comes from. What they're doing in high schools, though, the idea is that somebody screams, Andy's coming. Watch this
Andy's
in the hallway.
Coming.
And watch what everybody does.
Oh, my God.
Because that's what they did in the movie. Andy is the owner of the toys.
Right.
And when Andy came back into the room, you may remember, all the toys, quick, acted like they weren't really alive. And for some reason, this totally cracks me up. So we might not be good at the mannequin challenge, but I bet we could hit the deck for Andy's Coming. So we might want to be cool and
that's
go
so
with this
funny.
One. To me, it's funny that it surfaced from a 1995 movie.
Yeah, I've seen this a million times with my grandkids.
Exactly.
And no one thought to
we never hit the floor.
He's coming!
Joey's trying. Haley and I are like, damn, maybe not.
I don't know.
Actually, it started in 2013 on the now defunct Vine, but it has been coming back.
So a lot of these things have come back. Like, bye, Felicia. That was really old.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Yep. And we're still saying that all the time in my house. Speaking of that, it's time for the happy hour forecast. And when we come back, we have an upcoming fashion show for designing women. Stay with us.
Good afternoon. I'm Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan with your happy hour forecast. Looking pretty good, too. A lot of folks happy about those clouds getting out of here. And most of the area is now, for the most part, cloud-free. It's 76 at the airport. Sunshine and the dew point really quite nice at 50 degrees, and that means we're going to have a pretty cool night tonight. Northeast winds are at 5 miles an hour. The pressure at 29.92 inches, which is standard pressure, and that is holding steady now. You can see all the rain now down to our south associated with that frontal boundary, which continues to slide very slowly through the Fort Myers area and then places beyond. Now, as far as the satellite imagery goes, we had quite a bit of clouds around this morning. Those clouds have since moved on across most of the area. They're still hanging out over parts of Charlotte County and South Sarasota, but for the most part, generally fair skies over most of Sarasota and Manatee counties at this hour. Dry air is now moving in behind the front, so things are looking really quite nice for tomorrow. We'll have plenty of sunshine around. We'll have more in the forecast for the rest of this week coming up today at 5. Hope to see you then.
Designing Women Boutique accepts high-end fashions for donation and consignment. As a result, the boutique has donated nearly $2 million to arts and human services organizations over the years. One of the founders of Designing Women Boutique, Margaret Wise, is with us today to show us some gorgeous designer gowns perfect for this season's upcoming galas. So, Margaret, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
You're dressed for the occasion, we see.
Of course. A little enchanted evening here.
Yes, we're excited about this upcoming gala because it's going to be a little bit different. But before we get into that, let's talk about the boutique itself. If someone hasn't been in there, what can they find?
We can find high-end consignment, clothes, and beautiful furniture. And it's just a beautiful store. It's really, when you come in, you'll be very surprised because it doesn't look like most resale shops.
Right. Yeah.
It really is a high-end. We wanted something different and something very high-end and designer.
And you definitely got that because everyone raves about the store.
Yes, we have beautiful furniture and beautiful clothes, and you will see some of them today.
Right. And where do those...
High fashion.
Yes, they are. And where do they come from? Where do you all get the donations
from? Well, a lot of our friends, people around town, and a lot of people buy things and they never wear them, as you know, you've been in. Mm-hmm. We have things a lot of European things. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of European friends that come in, and they decide that they don't want to do it anymore. I mean, like, this dress was donated and from a bridal shop here.
Oh.
And then about a year, because it was brand new, but they had an overstock, and we give them a nice donation. Mm-hmm. We're 501c3, so they get a nice donation. And then about a year later, somebody from Europe brought this jacket in, and I said, you know, I think that'll work. So.
What are the odds?
Yeah.
And
it's perfect.
But and you match our logo, too. That I was just noticing.
I planned that. When you go a lot and you go in a lot, you're going to always find something. I never go in that door that I don't buy something. And my husband says it's the most expensive volunteer work you've ever done.
Right. It is. Okay, so let's start the fashion show. This year, the theme for the gala is in an evening in the Enchanted Garden. It will be at Selby Garden. So tell us about our first fairy.
This is Debbie Helen, and she is our fairy. And it really is Selby Gardens. If you haven't seen it lately, the new room that we have, we're going to be the first gala there.
Wow. That's great.
And the room is great. You're looking out with all the lights and the trees, and you're looking downtown. Across the bay at downtown, it really is enchanting, and that room is beautiful.
So this is not typically what you would buy at Designing Women
Boutique.
No,
this is
our for
theme,
the gala,
enchanted
right?
Enchanted garden,
but very cute.
So you come as a fairy.
Okay, so our next model.
You can if you want to. I'm coming as a fairy.
You can. Oh, why not?
Of course I am. Of course I am.
She's like, I am a fairy.
I am a fairy. All right, Cameron Scott, and that is a sequin party dress. It's a beautiful. Sequins are very in this year.
Oh,
very
lovely.
A lot of glitz this year.
New Year's Eve would be great.
New Year's Eve. Mm-hmm. Yes, but the glitz is very in this year.
It is.
So we love that, and we love her hairpiece. All her jewelry and all is from Designing Women, and she looks beautiful in
she
that.
She does.
Lovely.
And
yeah.
It's the price I think is $150.
Oh,
and it's a designer.
That's crazy.
And next is Jane Cameron.
I love this
look.
That's
regal.
That's
very
beautiful. Velvet, as you know, is so popular this year. And that's an Oscar de la Renta. Mm. That's a Escada. Excuse me. That's a Escada. The other one's Oscar. This is a Escada. And it really looks like it's never been worn.
It does.
The color, it's hard to pick up on camera, but in
beautiful.
Person,
it's
this beautiful, deep color.
And yes. Escada does it so beautiful. Somebody brought it in and had never worn it, but it was kind of had a thing in the middle. And we thought, hey, we're never going to get this out. We steamed it and sent it to the cleaners, and it's
brand new. Oh, I love it.
Her bag is beautiful, too.
And the bag is beautiful.
And the top,
it's all from Designing Women. And it's about $175.
That's amazing.
And this is Best Self, and this is Retro Hollywood Glam.
I'm loving this.
And that is an Oscar de la Renta. And those are vintage pins on them, on the Oscar de la Renta. And the hood comes down and makes a collar. And it's very retro, and I think it's just beautiful.
It's beautiful.
For the holidays.
Velvet is so in this year.
I love that.
Oh, that is gorgeous. And this
is Vicki Hornberger, who does so much of our styling.
Yes,
she really is such a wonderful model and does so much of our styling. And that's Festive Fantasy. And that came in, and she bought that today, $39. $39 when you bought that for $39.
Absolutely.
Oh, my goodness.
So, anyway, it's beautiful, and thank you so much, Vicki.
You're talking about everyone's outfit, but you have
But we
really
need to see
nice
Margaret,
one.
So Margaret's going to get up and show us her outfit.
I'm the biggest fairy of them all.
Oh, that is lovely.
It is.
Well, the color itself, such a pop.
Well, as everybody knows me, they know I love color. And I think life's in color, so why shouldn't I be, right?
Tell us about the dress.
The dress came from a bridal shop that had an overrun. I bought the dress, and about a year later, somebody brought this in from Europe, and I bought it, and I said, okay,
great.
It works.
So let's have all the ladies come back up.
Oh, my goodness.
A little of everything, from fairies to a night of elegance.
I mean, yes.
And a reminder, the Designing Women Gala is December 3rd. For tickets and more info, visit designingwomensrq.org. Congratulations to them for raising more than $2 million for more than 70 nonprofit organizations on the Suncoast over the years. And next, it's Money Matters with our financial expert.
Hurricane season is here, and Suncoast weather can go from this to this in seconds. So when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7.
We're armed with the most advanced weather technology so that we can bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
Plus, we focus on the Suncoast and track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
If you have a suspicion for harboring prostate cancer, we have a way of diagnosing by using an exquisite instrument called three-dimensional color flow power Doppler ultrasound. Using this system, we can identify abnormalities within the prostate that you could otherwise never detect. The Dottoli Cancer Center is the only center in the southeastern United States which has this technology. If you have prostate cancer, we will find it.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
If you're depressed, drinking, and using drugs, you may need help. And the Affordable Care Act guarantees coverage of substance abuse. Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking, and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Are you losing hope? You can recover and get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven, gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call the Addiction, Hope, and Helpline now for a free assessment with someone who cares.
Call 1-800-764-8708. That's 1-800-764-8708.
They care. They take the time to understand you, take the time to understand your case.
There's no better satisfaction to me than to see a client who is happy because of the job we've done for them.
It's really actually very comforting to know that there's someone that you've heard of and you're getting recommendations about. that you can turn to when you have a problem.
I felt like I had a partner in this, and he was going to be by my side.
And welcome back. With the recent presidential election, some are wondering what it will mean for the economy and where they should put their dollars. That's why our financial expert, Richard Stern, is here with some pointers on what we should be looking out for. Richard, welcome back. And hey, it's been up and down in the last few days. Well, a lot of ups, too, though.
You know, when I was here last Tuesday, we were talking about the fact that it was election day and, oh, my goodness, the market had been up 400 and some points because it appeared Hillary Clinton was going to win. Mm-hmm. So what happens? Donald Trump wins and the market goes up 470 points.
Wow. So it's hard to outguess this thing.
I've only been in the business 40 years, so I can't quite explain it. But, oh, well. But as a result, since Mr. Trump won and people are talking about what are called Trump stocks, just one quick disclaimer. My role here is not to say if you don't buy IBM in the next 10 minutes, you're making a huge mistake. Right. But that being said, I think we can talk about areas that most people believe will be beneficiaries of a Trump presidency. The first area is defense. Whether or not you agree with that, that's up to you. But in fact, defense is certainly thought to be something that will flourish under President Trump. And just three names to throw out to you, not recommendations, but names. Boeing is one, Northrop Grumman is another one, and Raytheon. Mm-hmm. All three of those would be stocks that could be beneficiaries based on the defense. Now, energy is an area, oil drilling, among other things, because the prices have been low and are probably going to go higher. Baker Hughes, Diamond Offshore, and a company called Schlumberger, which looks like Schlumberger, but it's Schlumberger.
That was where I lived in Houston, so
there
I
you
know
go.
Exactly how to pronounce
exactly.
Those are companies that drill the oil, not the actual oil companies.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
Exactly right. And healthcare is very interesting because I think we pretty well know that Obamacare is going to be gone. And Obamacare will be replaced by something. We don't know what something is, but presumably it won't be nearly as strict for a lot of the drug companies as Obamacare had been. And names to throw out there, again, are Johnson & Johnson, Lilly, and Pfizer. Now, there are a whole lot of areas in healthcare that one could look at, but those are major companies that I think we can keep in mind. And the last one, very importantly, is infrastructure. I think a lot of people think that under President Trump, you're going to see new bridges, new roads, lots of construction. Companies that take advantage of that are General Electric. Mm-hmm. And Caterpillar was up 7%.
Oh, I heard that.
Was up 7% the day after the election. And the reason being, people say, hey, if President Trump is going to do what he says he's going to do, Caterpillar has to be a beneficiary of all that earth being moved.
So, they built walls.
I was too easy. I'm sorry.
That was
too
easy.
Well, you probably need a Caterpillar thing to build a wall.
I bet you do.
Or a lot of them.
Yeah. Exactly so.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Richard. Always great advice and love to hear your perspective because you have so much experience in this.
Well,
and next, we're going to actually be speaking with the valet. And, hey, I might get a role. You never know.
A role?
Yeah. I'm
auditioning. My role.
We'll be right back.
Attention blood clot filter patients. Surgically implanted blood clot filters are potentially life-threatening. Some filters are prone to breaking, resulting in pieces of the filter moving through the body and causing internal bleeding. If you had surgery to implant a blood clot filter, you may be entitled to a cash award, even if you haven't suffered side effects yet. Call the Gold Shield Group now, 888-747-5291, to see if you qualify for a cash award, 888-747-5291.
You only have one life. Are you gambling with it? One in three adults have high blood pressure. Not knowing your numbers could cause you to lose big time. Luckily, you can turn the odds in your favor by getting your blood pressure checked today. Don't leave your health to chance. Learn more at heart.org/HPB.
Selling your home? Insist on a 3D showcase tour from Gulf Shores Realty. Virtual tours are flat and boring and look more like a slideshow than a tour. A 3D tour from Gulf Shores Realty is like actually walking through the home without the drive. Get instant access to your next home from any device. Multiple views give homebuyers a perspective like no other. For a limited time, mention ABC7 and Gulf Shores Realty will provide a complimentary 3D tour with your new listing.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. for a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Come meet the artists and enjoy their creations at the Sarasota Fine Art Festival. Over 100 artists and thousands of works of contemporary art in photography, glass, sculpture, jewelry, and much more. The 4th Annual Sarasota Fine Art Festival, Saturday and Sunday, November 19th and 20th at Selby Five Points Park in downtown Sarasota. Bring your love and appreciation of art to the Sarasota Fine Art Festival. For more information, visit ParagonArtEvents.com.
Being the caregiver for someone you love is truly a blessing, but sometimes you can lose a part of yourself. To be your best, for them and for you, it's important to have time to be able to recharge your batteries. When you call Tidewell Hospice, they can give you a chance to do just that, and with the peace of mind of knowing your loved one is in the very best hands. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
Welcome back to Suncoast View. Great looking sushi and chicken meatballs on the way from Japan Restaurant. Chef Andreas, that's a fancy Japanese name that you call your meatballs here, but I want to talk about the two different locations of Japan. Tell us where you are right now.
We have two locations right now. One is on the Paradise Plaza, and the other one is on UTC, in front of UTC Mall.
Okay, so something for both sides of town. And correct. Lunch and dinner at both? Talk
lunch
about your menus.
Lunch and dinner at both. We have like on the lunch special, we have a bento boxes and also like three roll special and two roll special also.
Okay, we look forward to learning about making the chicken meatballs with you. We'll see you in a few minutes. Linda?
The Sarasota Ballet is opening a triple bill this weekend. Three different ballets with very different styles of dance and music. It is extremely taxing for the dancers and extremely captivating for the audience. Artistic director Ian Webb is here with a description of the three different ballets and to give us a chance to be on stage with the professionals. Ian, I hate to say anything, but I was really a good dancer in my day.
I hate to brag.
I'm going to give you a chance to think this over, but why three different ballets?
Well, because it's challenging for the dancers, but also you can never make everybody happy. So if by doing a triple bill, hopefully somebody will go away with something that touches them, makes them feel better, and they'll leave, rather than trying to stick somebody in for just to see a full-length ballet and they start off and already have switched off.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You've got to keep changing it
so
all.
So different styles like then
different
when you make the program?
And I always try to do maybe sometimes in the middle will be something more theatrical or more sort of like with a statement or something that will create. And then to leave, I always try to make something that's gives you a lift and you go out of the theater. Sort of.
I know this area is known for the ballet and a lot of people that watch it love it. But do you think that strategy kind of helps get new people interested in the ballet?
For sure, because it is that same old thing where you get sort of, particularly with the guys, they go, I don't want to go and see the ballet, but you can always change it up. And it also gives you a chance to do a different, somebody may be more interested in the music, so they maybe don't want to go and see, you know, 2.5 hours of Tchaikovsky, but if you put Stravinsky in there, other composers, it also gives that
I love the
element.
Idea.
Now, this
that's
is the one that's quite different. This is Ashton's, and you say the name of it.
Sinfonietta.
Sinfonietta, I knew that. You gave us a chance to watch this rehearsal. Tell us about what this requires of the dancers.
This is the third movement of it, and it is nonstop. It's, when I chose to bring this into the repertoire, I'd forgotten how sort of like exhausting it is, because I just think, see, they're moving the whole time, the body, the shoulders, they don't stop. And I just remember just bouncing and enjoying it and forgot quite how tricky it was. But they do a great job. And
it's
it was
lovely.
A ballet that was going to be lost, so by us bringing it back, it again gives it, because it's a wonderful piece.
It was
piece.
Captivating.
Yeah, it was.
At the rehearsal, we could not get enough of the energy and the athleticism.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
Well, Tudor's Gala is also on this bill. And we understand that you may want to cast us in this one.
I see that you're trying to influence him. I saw the subliminal messages going on, trying
to
get a part.
Remember,
on.
Yeah.
I have to use everything I've got at this point,
very
ladies. Okay, let's take a look at our audition.
Okay.
See how we really did.
you're gonna hold this arm strong, and you're gonna lift your chin up and look gorgeous.
I got that part.
I love it. Excellent, excellent. Okay. What happened to your elbow? Look where your arm is and look where my arm is. There we go. Now, remember what I said to start with? Tummy up, seat down. Very nice. Round, long arms. Good.
Not straight.
Water flowing down.
I like your touch. It was tickly.
Oh. Good. So, but what about the arm?
Oh, okay.
At the same time. This means I'm about to do my dance. You better watch me.
Okay.
Right? Okay. Turn your palm over. Now bend your knees. Arm comes down. And then your arms comes up. And we open. Lovely. Oh. Make sense?
Yes.
See?
Yes.
And this is called a demi-plié.
Demi-plié.
And every dancer does it every single day of their life at the beginning of the day. Demi-plié. Not bad. So, Suncoast View ladies, here are our three ballerinas. And these are the roles you're auditioning for. This is our French ballerina, and she's always bubbly and excitable, and everything is so much fun. Is that you?
I see.
Yes. Good. Now this is our Italian ballerina. She's a little over it. She's been dancing a long time, and she thinks everyone is beneath her. And of course, she has the biggest headdress of the whole piece, which is quite something you might want. You might want that headpiece, exactly. And finally, we have our Russian diva ballerina. As you can see, she's very nonplussed about everything. And she's a bit of a cow. Yeah. Everything is beneath her. So, you've seen our three ballerinas. Who do you think you are?
I would like to be French.
You'd like to be French?
I would.
And why would you like to be French?
Je suis français, fun and bubbly.
Oh, I love it, I love it. Okay, French.
I think I'm a mix of the next two.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a little bit of a demonstrative kind of personality going on, but at the same time, I'm pretty cool, calm, and collected most times, I think. No?
Okay, maybe. Okay.
They're like, yeah, right, no, you're not. That's the opposite. That's your
new mother.
Linda
about
would definitely be
Linda wants to wear the headdress.
Linda wants the headdress.
Yes. Linda will definitely be there.
She will want to be in the middle.
Okay.
That might make you Russian.
That might make me Russian.
Could make you Russian, yeah.
And then you have the hands to push.
Yeah. What about just move?
Do they get the roles?
Well, you see, this is a situation that I'm in quite often because I think all of you are perfect casts for all the different roles you could bring.
Oh, look at that.
So that's why we'll do, this time we're doing four performances. So we're doing the opening night, and that's always the tricky one, and then two shows Saturday and a Sunday matinee.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I would probably put you on in the different roles on different nights.
I like
but
that.
But research is always important. And I think that Linda wasn't there in the rehearsal, but she already looked at the colour.
Yes, but I've been dancing so long, I shouldn't have to.
You've danced all this time, and you're wearing the right colour.
That's right.
That I think that you definitely need.
Oh, she gets the role. Made it.
There we go.
I'm a ballerina. Glad I didn't audition. I might not be here in this moment.
And we would have added a Sunday evening, but then we'd have had to put Joey on there. So we figured we'll just do that.
This. They can dance a lot better than we can. It's this weekend's triple bill. Balanchine, Ashton, and Tudor. It's November 18th through the 20th at the Sarasota Opera House. For tickets, go to sarasotaballet.org. Who knows? You may see us on stage. Next, we're going to get ready for a holiday travel. We can pack better than we can dance.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC7. We're here for you.
Need more space in your place? The More Space Place can help. With Murphy beds that disappear to reveal a home office, living room, or den. Custom closets with designated areas for your shoes, bags, wardrobe, and accessories. Custom-built entertainment centers, garage storage systems, and more. The More Space Place has three showrooms next to Sonny's on US 41 South in Sarasota, on Lakewood Ranch Boulevard just south of State Route 64 in Bradenton, and on Tamiami Trail next to Panera Bread in Port Charlotte. Put more space in your place at the More Space Place.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what we're working on now for 5 o'clock. A sentencing for Sarasota's first human trafficking case, a severe penalty that prosecutors hope will set an example for any similar cases in the future. And it's one man and a vintage tractor, how the Sarasota man is choosing to spread awareness and raise money for wounded veterans. Now let's get a check on our weather with Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Bob?
Thanks, Scott. Sunshine spreading across the area as a result of that cold front now, which is now to our south for the most part. We still have some clouds lingering near Charlotte County, but this front will continue to move off to the southeast, and behind it, some slightly cooler temperatures. Tomorrow's lows will be much and noticeably cooler into the mid-50s, even some lower 50s well inland. Right now it's 76. The dew point is so low now at 50 degrees, and the barometer 29.92 inches. Winds out of the northeast, and clouds clearing. We'll have much more in our forecast coming up at 5. See you then.
The all-new MySuncoast.com. Just another way we're here for you.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free. And services.com. A-N-D services.com.
I owed the IRS $10,000.
I owed the IRS $20,000.
The IRS garnished my wages.
They put a lien on my house.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency in the world. They do not give up until you pay.
I couldn't sleep. We were being audited. I called Tax Solutions Now, and a great big weight was lifted off my shoulders.
I called Tax Solutions Now, and they got the IRS off my back.
Tax Solutions Now had my wage garnishment lifted in 48 hours.
Tax Solutions Now can get you help. Our agents know the rules, can stop the pain, and get you the best deal.
We saved our home and overcame the most powerful collection agency in the world.
We connect you with a team of former IRS agents and tax professionals who get the IRS off your back.
Time is running out. Call Tax Solutions Now.
Call 1-800-565-7740. That's 1-800-565-7740.
Procreme by Dr. Anna, known as the facelift in a bottle, is an all-natural anti-aging formula that tightens skin and muscles, making you look younger. It's made in Sarasota with real pearls, Chinese herbs, and no preservatives. Visit our store or at pearlcreambydranna.com.
Okay, we all love our weekends away, but how good of a packer are you really? So we're going to have a little packing contest here.
Okay.
Big pile of clothes, small carry-on bag. This is the carry-on challenge. How much can you get in it in 1 minute? Okay. So Haley, bend down for me and grab that big band of clothes. Ooh. These are clean clothes. Laundry.
Thank the Lord.
We both have the same amount.
Wow. Okay.
And articles of clothing.
All this goes in there?
Well, yes. That's the game. We're gonna see how much we can do it. So use whatever you do, you roll, you fold, you stuff. We're gonna get a minute on the clock. Joey, you got it?
And it's them against us?
It's them against us.
You guys don't have a
Five,
chance.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Whose pants are these? Oh my goodness.
One. No, you can't do it.
Well, don't
how
redo
about,
mine.
How about you fold, and then I'll tuck it.
Okay.
How long are we going for? I think we've got 10 pair of pants.
Yeah, we're just wearing pants on this trip. You're going topless.
I've folded 5 pair of pants.
Well, dig through the pile. I think there's other shirts. I like this shirt. Can I keep this?
More pants. I like rolling them.
Yeah, you can do rolling.
So they squeeze more in. And they swear they won't be wrinkled.
Oh my gosh, 10 seconds.
What's rolling the second?
Okay, here, do this one.
We don't have any.
Don't spit on Superman's cape.
I don't think it matters what we brought. Are we supposed to have underwear?
Yes, you have to have
Listen, I've gone many places without underwear. All right, we've got everything we could get in there. Whoa,
oh,
girls.
We got more than you did.
Well, I don't know about that. Now, I did forget to issue one rule, that it had to be wearable.
Wearable?
I don't know.
I don't know about Superman's.
So what are you guys, they're going to count?
We didn't stuff it. I think we did at least fold.
Okay,
and so we didn't like.
I think they got way more in there. Yeah. They're going off to count the items, and I have a feeling Bo Beth and I did not do as well. But listen, these are the expert tips. This is from Condé Nast Traveler. Fold, don't roll your clothes. Now, Bo Beth is a roller. And
I am too.
I thought that made it more neat, but apparently you get more in if you just fold.
I think because you can make it flatter.
Okay, stuff to maximize space. You know, like the socks in the corner, the underpants in the little drawers. Uh-huh. Right, stuff your shoes full of things. Speaking of shoes, three pairs only, and I find this impossible.
Three.
Listen to why. You have the comfortable walking shoes, one pair of dressy shoes, and flip-flops to stay off the nasty hotel carpet.
Smart. Okay.
And that's it.
You might need one more, like a flat. Well,
I think that's the comfortable shoes.
See,
but
if you're my mother, you bring an entire suitcase of just shoes.
Well, and how do you only have one pair of dressy shoes? Because how do you know it'll go with all the outfits?
I sometimes plan the dressy outfits in that
around the shoes.
Because the heels take up so much more space.
Room. Yep. And then rely on multifunctional items. You don't want to use just, you know, something that only charges one item. You want to use something you can curl with and blow with and straighten with. And, you know, because for me, it's appliances. By the time you bring the hair dryer, the flat iron, the curly, I never knew I was so high maintenance.
I can't believe that all their bag is empty and look at all this clothes.
I guess Haley's a good packer. I am a pretty good packer. Do we have results coming in here? Oh, here, bring that thing up here.
What?
There we go. All right, here come the results. Steph and Bo Beth got in six pairs of pants, four shirts, and one pair of PJs. Oops, someone's sleeping naked. Not me. All right, Haley and Linda got in 10 pants, seven shirts, and one pair of PJs.
I knew it.
They definitely got more in. I guess we're not speed packers, but I think ours was neater.
Yeah, and we had more room.
Here's one thing I did do, though. I did in my actual suitcase. Stuff some of the stuff that doesn't wrinkle too much in like
the
sides, the crevices, because you don't realize how much space is, you know, is down there. Like PJs or, you know, socks, just stuff
it
in.
I'm calling you guys my next nut cracking. That's all right. It's not always
about
speed.
We'll be glad to help you.
It's not always about speed.
All right. Well, it was about speed yesterday and height. Wait till you see us on the rock wall. Haley, you can be glad you missed this. Stay with us.
Hurricane season is here, and so is the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. This essential resource arms you with vital information you need to protect your family and property when severe weather threatens the Suncoast, including how to create your readiness plan and survival kit, shelter locations, what to do with pets, and important phone numbers. Visit mysuncoast.com and download the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. Brought to you by the Florida Lottery. Speed, power, and excitement come to ABC7 Sunday, November 20th with live coverage of the Inglewood Beach Water Fest. See the World Championship for the Offshore Powerboat Association with boats running at speeds up to 180 miles per hour. Join Bob Harrigan for complete coverage from noon to 3 on Sunday, November 20th or watch on the ABC7 channel on Amazon Fire TV. Go to mysuncoast.com for more info. Brought to you by Mr. Sparky. Presented by ABC7 and WENG Radio.
Gold fever has once again swept the nation. And everyone is rushing to Florida to strike it doubly rich. Introducing the $5 million Gold Rush Doubler. We're doubling cash prizes for over $752 million in payouts. And 36 prizes from $1 million to $5 million. The Florida Gold Rush is on. The Florida Lottery. Just imagine.
Christmas traditions by LuxArts Silks, where more is merrier. Make your holidays sparkle with style. Browse our amazing showroom, cute collectible cottages, and beautiful Christmas displays. Find the inspiration, selection, and quality you need to deck the halls merry and bright. Christmas traditions also features the area's largest selection of quality pre-lit Christmas trees. Every size, shape, and color, and plenty of decorations to make your home shine for the holidays. Christmas traditions by LuxArts Silks, where more is merrier. Visit us on New 301, just a quarter mile north of University Parkway.
Your home is the largest investment you have. So when you're looking for furniture, window treatments, and accessories from America's top brands like Henridon, American Leather, and Hunter Douglas, the only place you need to go is Bacon's. Quality, service, price. Bacon's Furniture and Design, Sarasota.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
Welcome back. Bobeth, are you sore today?
I am a little.
I wondered if your body would be sore because she had to haul it up a rock wall yesterday.
Complain. I don't know what you guys are complaining about.
Yeah, you were
not sore at all.
So, Haley, yesterday we took to the sky, literally, Kelly Jaco there of Jaco.
Yeah, that's unfair competition.
You know what? I'm glad she was there because that kept her busy doing the wall. Well, Bobeth did a pretty good job, too. So, we attempted to scale the wall. Kelly got all the way to the top. Bobeth got about halfway up and then got stuck on like a lump that she couldn't get over.
I was too short. My hands couldn't reach around.
And I very honestly never made it off the ground because I have a bad left arm and it takes all four arms and legs to do this, I learned very, very quickly. Mm-hmm. But this is Kelly Cam. We had the camera strapped to her head and it was kind of a dizzying view of what you see as you go up. But look at her muscles. I mean, Kelly is in phenomenal shape. But
yes,
here's the thing.
Is.
She said this was hard to do and not too many people are in the kind of
also,
shape she was in.
Also, strategically, it's hard. Like you were saying, Bobeth, if you get on the wrong little hook and you can't reach the next one, you kind of do get stuck.
You're stuck.
Yeah, there's Kelly Cam. You can see how you kind of have to look to decide what you're going to grab next. But it's a lot of fun. That is Derek from, what's the name of his company again? Up in the Air Fun.
Uh-huh.
And you can rent the rock wall. It's honestly a great team building event and something like the teenagers. His son came, scampered up it like it was no big deal.
That's a good party idea.
It is. It's a great party idea.
And
so we did have a lot of fun.
And I love watching
you guys. They have other things too, not just a rock wall.
Correct. So lots of good stuff there. We're going to see that segment again on Thanksgiving Day in its entirety. Right now we are headed to the kitchen. We are anxious to make Chinese meatballs with J-Pan. Stay with us.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at the top of the hour.
It's no longer used for phosphate production, but it still sits as a threat to the environment, holding water atop the stack.
Remaining water at a former phosphate mine is posing an environmental hazard in the area. The steps officials are putting into place to prevent an incident from happening. Let's go over to Bob for another look at our weather.
Thanks, Scott. I'll tell you what, the tropical season officially ends November 30th, but we still have a couple of weeks left, and there could be a storm forming. We'll talk more about this down in the Caribbean, south of Jamaica here in just a little bit. We are looking at a cold front that has made its way through our area. It's down to the south now, and some cooler and drier air has filtered in, but not nearly as strong as the next front that is on the way. Details and all that coming up at 5. Obviously, 76 right now. Plenty of sunshine out there. We'll hope to see you then.
ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights.
These are our heroes. They have sacrificed so much to serve our country. And now Granny Nannies is truly honored to serve them. We're here and we're ready to help. Call us today.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Minnesota Flooring.
And for a limited time, Minnesota Flooring is offering you unbelievable pricing on tile and laminate. Porcelain tile, only $1.59. Ceramic tile, 99 cents. And 16 by 16 tile, $1.19. Laminate flooring is only 99 cents. But these prices won't last. Don't miss out on these great deals. Hurry into Minnesota Flooring today.
An important message for Americans eligible for Medicare.
Are you receiving all the benefits available to you? Do you know there is money available to lower your Medicare prescription costs? Now's the time to find the coverage that's right for you at the right price. The way to do that is to explore your options. You can spend hours doing that yourself, or you can call Health Markets and let us do the legwork for you with no cost or obligation. We'll search a variety of plans from nationally recognized companies to find the coverage that's the best fit for you at a price that fits your budget, and we'll do it at no charge to you. Plus, you may be able to save money on prescriptions. We'll tell you if you qualify. Why pay a penny more than you have to for an insurance policy? Let us find you the right plan at the right price and see if you qualify to lower your prescription costs. Put our free service to work for you at no charge.
Call the number on the screen now to make sure you're getting all the benefits you deserve. Don't wait. Call now.
Alex Karras Lincoln's holiday sales event is here. Drive a brand new 2017 Lincoln MKC Sports Utility for $269 per month or a 2017 MKZ for $299 per month. We are proud to introduce the newest addition to the Lincoln lineup, the all-new 2017 Lincoln Continental. We have a great selection and ready for immediate delivery. Alex Karras Lincoln, affordable luxury. Winner of the prestigious 2015 President's Award, serving Florida's Sun Coast since 1978. We're located 2 miles north of the Sarasota-Bradenton Airport on US 41.
At Granny Nanny's, we provide your loved ones with the care they deserve, compassionate and experienced help right where you need it most, at home. Visit us at grannynannies.com.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Coming up Wednesday at 4 on Suncoast View, it's one of the hottest tickets in town as the traditional Christmas story comes alive with a gospel twist. We will preview West Coast Black Theater's Black Nativity, plus Booker High School is here with a dance performance. We'll also learn how to make holiday place settings for just pennies. And calorie alert, girls, Chef Judy has the best Thanksgiving pies and desserts. We better work out today.
We are back in the kitchen with Chef Andreas from J-Pan, and we are making chicken meatballs today. Okay, and this
Sukuni.
Is... Say it again.
Sukuni.
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 Okay.
I was wondering if you were going to say it. I was laughing.
Chef Andreas is a lot better than I do. So tell us how we can get started helping you make these today.
So you start with a little bit of ground chicken.
Okay.
Then you can just start helping me adding a little bit of green onion.
Yep. Dump everything
in?
Okay.
And this one is a sea salt.
A sea salt?
Yeah.
Whoops, this one is salt?
That's sugar.
Sugar.
Okay.
All of the sugar?
Yeah, all of it.
Okay.
And this
and
is
then
what?
That's miso paste.
Miso paste,
If you don't have miso, you can substitute with some salt.
And can you get that at most grocery stores?
Yes.
Do
miso
we have to
paste?
Go to
what is this?
That's a ginger.
Ginger.
Fresh ginger.
Fresh ginger.
Yep.
Yeah.
My ginger doesn't look like that. And this one
and
is?
Soy sauce.
Soy sauce, of course.
And cornstarch.
Cornstarch.
Both of those go in there?
Both of them are cornstarch.
Yeah.
Huh.
So does that help hold it together?
Yeah.
Okay. So
did I miss that one or does
no,
it not
that's from the last one. And egg white.
Egg white.
Yeah.
Oh, also help hold it together.
Okay, Haley.
Okay, so how do we do this?
You just mix it with the spatula.
With the spatula?
Yep. Or you, with your hand.
With your hand. You can squish it.
You know me in the kitchen.
There you go.
All right,
Linda. Go in there.
Oh,
yeah,
this
you have to knead it
memories.
Until it's turned a little bit pale, so you kind of hold it together.
Okay, well, let's
all
use
right.
the magic of TV. Yeah. I know if I want to eat that one.
So,
Linda's going to town.
Mine's
so this
ready.
Is the finished product,
okay.
So it's a little bit pale. So you can just make it like a, you can put in the skewer with the help
of
like
a... So you do, kind of, you serve them lollipop style with skewers if you want,
or
you could just make them flat.
Oh,
so, Bobeth, here's your goal.
I think I did it wrong.
Here's your goal.
Yeah,
you want it to look that way.
Okay, so what am I supposed to do with this?
Yeah, for me, I give a little bit trick, so I put a little bit of oil on my glove.
I wish I would have known that.
Oh, that's like stuck all over. Well, Chef, let's cook these or have you do the ones that you're making too, because again,
all right, I'll try.
No offense, but I'm not eating that one either.
We're ready over here when you need ours.
Yeah, we're still.
There we go. His look nicer than
this.
Yours.
Is this the right thing? Is this oil?
No, that's sake.
That's
what
sake.
Are you doing?
Oh, that tastes good, though.
Oh, my goodness. Beth is making sake meatballs.
I didn't
It might be a good creation.
I know.
Yes, you are a
it
mess.
It may taste good.
This is why we have a chef. So how long do those cook there in the oil?
It's about 2 minutes on both sides.
Wow, this is a great quick dinner.
So it's almost Thanksgiving, so you can use a turkey also.
Oh, that would be good.
Good idea. Might be a good use for some leftover turkey to grind it up and make meatballs. But the Asian seasoning, definitely a nice treat. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do some sampling of the ones that are safely made by the chef. So go ahead and pass those down. I love the Asian flavors in there. So thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Two locations of J-Pan, both lunch and dinner with special memories. Chef Ian, come on. Chef Ian. Ian Webb from Sarasota Ballet. Come on in and enjoy some wonderful food. Don't forget the triple bill at the ballet this weekend. And I'm not going to eat too much of this because I must fit into my costume as I will be putting them on stage.
Dutch courage.
Yes. And this makes it all easier to do. So thank you to everybody for joining us. Be sure to take some time and enjoy the Suncoast view.
I'm fine.